Some of them are quite young. In fact, three of the artists are below 18. So what did you think of picking them up? Did you see some, or do you see some potential in them?
The three young artists are people we know. Basically, while we were organizing this exhibition, while we were planning it, was in the pipeline. They've been with us and around us, and they also mentioned that they sketched or they drew, and just out of sheer excitement, we just told them, you know, why don't you show us your works, let's have a look, because they were so excited, look at all the paintings, all the big artists. And then they bought their works and we said they're really good, let's put them up in the exhibition. It gives them a boost, gives them an encouragement to go ahead in life and, you know, continue painting, do better. If they're already exhibiting at such a young age, they look forward to doing more work, to doing better work. They learn because they have a keen interest in art. They look at the paintings, they learn, they'll try to pick pointers. So we thought we'd give them a chance. We got Joel Silveira, who's all of 16. And he's, right now his inspiration is Michael Jackson, and he does a lot of Christ. He's related to me, so I guess the inspiration for Christ comes from there. We got Diksha, Radhika Kherkar. Radhika does a lot of fantasy art. She uses a lot of vibrant colors. She's also 16 years old. She hails from Bombay. And she's actually done a painting of a mask, Venetian mask, you could call it, of the carnival feel, basically just for Goa. So she was preparing for this exhibition. We also have another kid, Irwin Coelho. And he's done a certain form of art where he's painted everything in black completely. So we made him with shadow art. And his works are really good. So if you have a look, he's only in the sixth standard. He's about 11 years old. So these guys were genuinely very, very excited about the exhibition. So we thought it would only be right to include them and make them a part of it and give them some encouragement and boost. So that's about it.
Coming back to your paintings, you do finger paintings. So why did you think of doing that? Even though it was done, as you said, to stand apart. Mm-hmm. How do you do it? I mean, why did you think of, you know, putting it aside, brush aside, and then start painting, finger painting?
Okay, that's...
I mean, your paintings are very precise in the sense they don't look like they have been painted with fingers, because they have the fine lines that is required that can be brought about by brush.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a question I've been asked by a lot of people generally also. It's a very funny answer actually. I used to paint with brushes as a kid, and even during college, and you know, I used to use a lot of hands because you need to clean your brushes so many times for different colors. Even if you have a big bundle of brushes, you have to keep washing them. So, you know, sometimes they dry off and you can just get lazy sometimes after painting for too many hours, and I would just use my hands a lot. And then one fine day I said, let me just try using my hands instead of a brush, just like that, offhand. And I did a pretty okay job. And so I showed it to my mom and I showed it to everyone, and they said, you can't say it's done with your hands and not the brush. So I said, let me just try and let me just use my hands. So over the months, I just started painting with my hands and I was doing a little better every day. And when I had to exhibit my first exhibition, I said, let me just do a finger painted exhibition to create impact. And I got a very, very good response and people really loved it. And it was really written about, and people were surprised that they were actually finger painted. And I said, I'm never going to touch the brush again. I don't need to. God-given tools.
That's true. Tell me about your exhibitions. How many exhibitions do you have till date? I think they are pretty big amount.
Yeah, I've done quite a few. It'll be a little difficult to give you an exact number, but I've done close to about maybe about 10 or 11 in Bombay. Including I've done Kala Ghoda, the biggest art festival in Bombay. I've done that about three times. This is my third show in Goa. And I've showed in cities like Delhi, Chandigarh, in the Punjab University. We've showed around Himachal, Bangalore. I've shown in Delhi two times. I might not remember all the names. Then I've done shows abroad as well. My first show was in Vienna, in Austria. It was a group show of 30 artists, and something really interesting happened there. There's another artist called Salvador Dali, who I guess every person who knows art knows. He's one of the magicians of art. And one of his assistants, his main assistants, was exhibiting in that art as well, in that art show, in the exhibition. And it was such an inspiration to see his works in the same room as my works. Okay. And we were putting up our paintings and he was putting up his, and I actually stood there and stopped putting up my paintings and just looking at his paintings for like the last 4, 5 or 10 minutes. I just stood there and I was in such awe. That was one of the most memorable experiences, I think, to have his assistant exhibit over there. Apart from that, I've done Germany twice. I've done Greece. I haven't been there myself, but my paintings have. I've done Australia, London.
आमच्या बरोबर हे ऑर्गनायजींग टिमाचे हे एग्जिबिशन जे घाला जे मलिशा आणि रोवन हे दोघी जण आसा ऑर्गनायजींग टिमाचे मेंबर्स तांचे कडेन उलोया. वेलकम टू द शो. टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट दिस डिफरंट द एग्जिबिशन टायटल डिफरंट.
वेल एग्जिबिशन डिफरंट इज बेसिकली बाय द नेम इटसेल्फ इट्स क्वाइट नोन दॅट इट्स डिफरंट. वी हॅव एव्हरीथिंग राईट फ्रॉम पेंटिंग्स, फोटोग्राफ्स. यू कॅन सी देर आर सम टी शर्ट्स. वी हॅव बॉटल आर्ट इन द बॉटल आर्ट. And what is more different is we have a lot of different artists. So we don't have just watercolors and finger painting. We have a lot of impressionism. We have a lot of abstracts. We have landscapes. We have oil on canvas. We have acrylic on canvas. So basically there's something different for everybody who walks into this room. So that was the main objective, so that people who walk out don't go disappointed. Because there are some people who are not so interested in paintings, they are interested in photography. So we have a wide range of photographs displayed here. So that's about the exhibition.
Rowan, tell me about the eclectic mix of artists. Some are Goans, some are non-Goans, some are abstract artists that you have selected.
Okay. The thing is that we just chose the best. And since Alex is good friends with most of the artists, we let him decide on choosing the art work to be displayed here. And Alex has actually been to Bombay and seen the art that is to be displayed, and he is the one who selected the artwork which you can see around you. And apart from that, the bottle art, which is the most amazing thing which I can see right in front of me right now, is also done by Alex. And that's about it. That's about the difference of the art that you can see here.
But we've had Libretta, Rodrigues. We have had Prashali Gaikwad. Mona Singh, she is deaf and mute. She is a wonderful, wonderful artist. You have to capture hers. We also have Sunil Pavle, who does a lot of work with watercolors. We have Meena Rastogi, who works with oil on canvas. And quite a more. We have Shilpa Shah. We have Rajesh, a photographer, a well-known photographer, the award winner of Lonely Planet. He also has displayed his photographs over here.
Why did you all think of having it here in Goa?
Basically, when you think of Goa, you think of Goa as a tourist destination. When you think about art markets, you say, the thing what would definitely come out first on your mouth is Mumbai, Delhi, all the metropolitan cities. Nobody thinks of Goa as an art market because Goa is branded as a tourist destination. So what we have decided now is that since Goa has a lot of art in itself, be it musicians, dancers, we have a lot of painters, which I see through your program. So we thought of selecting this destination. Moreover, because Alex is originally a Goan, so he always had a wish of having his exhibitions in Goa. He's had his exhibitions all over the world, as he must have explained to you, in London and other parts of Europe. So Goa is always very close. It's our home. So we said, why not showcase his art to the Goans here? That was the reason why.
And what are your plans now? Since this is a quite successful exhibition, what are your plans?
Our future plans are basically to promote art and music in Goa, have exchange programs, have a lot of more artists coming from other cities, even other countries, come over here, exhibit, and promote our Goan musicians as well as artists abroad. Maybe we plan to take some of our local Goan artists abroad to other countries in the future. I hope that happens soon.
Different now exhibition, Alex Rodrigues, so one of the members, Tajikadin Mulele, and the organizer Kadin Mulele. तुमका हे नक्कीच आवडला असेल एक्झिबिशन आपण दुबाव ना आमची आयची कार्यावळ हांगाच सोंपता तुमचे जर कसले सजेशन्स असले जाल्यार आमकां ह्या पत्याचेर कळोवचें nagesh@prudentmedia.in तर परत मेळ्या फुडले बिरेस्तारा सांजवेच्या 7:30 वरांचेर तो मेरेन पळयत रावात प्रुडंट मिडिया